I think I realised after my second solo album, which I sang, that's partly why I didn't do it again, that I'm happy working in collaboration with people. And I think for me the mechanics was always about doing the same as Genesis, you know, co-writing, but different people. And so it sounded different, it felt different from the word go. Come beating on your door. I've learned one simple thing about songwriting in the last 45 years of doing it, is you can't push it. If it ain't happening, you can't just push on and make it happen. I learned one thing many years ago. If I go in the studio and try and write a song and it's not working, I'll go and go for a walk, put the dogs out, do something else. I will not try and force it, because I can do more in 10 minutes that's good than 10 days is bad. So on that premise, I've learned to not try too hard. That's the key, really. Still to conversation. It was a funny time back, it must have been the late 80s, when suddenly, I remember the American charts had Mechanics song, Genesis song, Phil Collins song, Peter Gabriel song, I think Steve had GTR, Bam, and Steve Howe, all in the top sort of 30. It's interesting what came out of that one band, because people to this day don't quite know, a lot of guys don't know that Phil Collins is in Genesis, or Peter Gabriel was, or vice versa. And I still hear today very often, you mean you're the Mike? From Mike and the Mechanics, you know, and vice versa. And you're in Genesis. People don't know these things, and it's not that important, but from this one nucleus of songwriters, so much happened. I've always had a fascination with the generational change from my father's era, who was born in 1906, you know, had two world wars, and they came out of World War II, I think, shell-shocked. And until my generation, young men of 20 want to become their fathers, wear the same trousers, wear the same jackets, do the same things. And something happened in the early 60s with the Beatles, and I suppose England sort of in shock after the World Wars, and this kind of cultural change happened. And I think that huge generational change hasn't been written about very much. And so the book is about, obviously it's about the band, Genesis, the Mechanics, and Peter and Phil and Tony and Ann. But it's also about that era in the UK, which I think was pretty much unique and led the world too, I think. I've forgotten one of the early songs we had, and I think that when you see it as a body of work in one on one CD, and CD two is actually the lot of unreleased B-sides. I was impressed. I mean, it sounded great. I enjoyed, felt very proud of some of the songs there. I guess the process of choosing all these songs together for the singles collection package was actually fun for me to do, because I hadn't heard some of the songs for a while. And you go back and you kind of go, I've forgotten that song. And the Mechanics had an awful lot of radio hits as well as record hits. And I think putting it all together as a body of work was being actually for me quite satisfying and really enjoyable.